Hello and welcome to MJ School of Mining and Geology Private Tutoring YouTube channel. Please don't forget to like, share and subscribe to our channel for more content like this. In today's lesson, we are going to learn more about Bowen's reaction series, which is the fundamental concept to understand magmatic differentiation in geology. This is Norman L. Bowen, an experimental petrologist in the early 1900s, who realized this from his determinations of simple two- and three-component phase diagrams, and proposed that if an initial basaltic magma had crystals removed before they could react with the liquid, the common suite of rocks from basalt to rhyolite could be produced. This is summarized as Bowen's reaction series. Bowen suggested that the common minerals that crystallize from magmas could be divided into a continuous reaction series and a discontinuous reaction series. These two branches occur at higher temperatures associated with mafic and intermediate magmas. The continuous branch describes the evolution of the plagioclase feldspars as they evolve from being calcium-rich to more sodium-rich. The discontinuous branch describes the formation of mafic minerals such as olivine, pyroxene, amphibole, and biotite mica. This can be quickly remembered as old people are boring, where old represent olivine, people represent pyroxene, or represent amphibole, whereas boring represents biotite. However, as the degree of fractional crystallization increases, more felsic components such as olivoclase, muscovite, and quartz can be produced. This can be remembered as omi-quartz. The continuous reaction series is composed of the plagioclase feldspar solid solution series. A basaltic magma would initially crystallize a calcium-rich plagioclase and upon cooling continually react with the liquid to produce more sodium-rich plagioclase. If the early forming plagioclase were removed, then liquid compositions could eventually evolve to those that would crystallize a sodium-rich plagioclase, such as a rhyolite liquid in a process known as fractional crystallization, which will be discussed in the later stage of this video. Another way to think of continuous series is, this is the branch in which the composition ranges between only end members of the plagioclase feldspars. Therefore, the silicate is the framework silicate only, hence, the name continuous series because the composition is only feldspar. The structures of the minerals in the continuous series do not change, meaning the structure is only a framework or tectosilicate. The discontinuous reaction series, on the other hand, consists of minerals that upon cooling eventually react with the liquid to produce a new phase. Thus, crystallization of olivine from a basaltic liquid would eventually reach a point where olivine would react with the liquid to produce orthopyroxene. Bowen postulated that with further cooling pyroxene would react with the liquid, which by this time had become more enriched in H2O, to produce hornblende. The hornblende would eventually react with the liquid to produce biotite. If the earlier crystallizing phases are removed before the reaction can take place, then increasingly more siliceous liquids would be produced. Another way to think of discontinuous series is, the composition occurs within a wide-range chemical composition and within a wide range of silicates, example, olivine is a nesosilicate, pyroxene is a single-chain inosilicate, amphibole is a double-chain inosilicate, mica is a sheet silicate. In discontinuous series, the structures of the minerals vary from nesosilicate to sheet silicate. Fractional crystallization is the process that increases the magma silica content, making the magma more felsic. As the temperature drops within a magma diapir rising through the crust, some minerals will crystallize and settle to the bottom of the magma chamber, leaving behind the remaining melt depleted of those ions. For example, olivine is a mafic mineral at the top of the Bowen's reaction series with a high melting point and a smaller percentage of silica versus other common igneous minerals. When ultramafic magma cools, the olivine crystallizes first and settles to the bottom of the magma chamber. This means the remaining melt becomes more silica-rich and felsic. As the mafic magma further cools, the next minerals on Bowen's reaction series such as plagioclase and pyroxene crystallize next, removing even more low silica components from the magma, making it even more felsic. This crystal fractionation can occur in the oceanic lithosphere, but the formation of more differentiated, highly evolved felsic magma is largely confined to continental regions where the longer time to the surface allows more fractionation to occur. This generalized idea is consistent with the temperatures observed in magmas and with the mineral assemblages we find in the various rocks. We would expect that with increasing silica, oxides like magnesium oxide, and calcium oxide should decrease with higher degrees of crystal fractionation because they enter early crystallizing phases, like olivines and pyroxenes. Oxides like water, potassium oxide, and sodium oxide should increase with increasing crystal fractionation because they do not enter early crystallizing phases. Furthermore, we would expect incompatible trace element concentrations to increase with fractionation, and compatible trace element concentrations to decrease. This is generally what is observed in igneous rock suites. Because of this, and the fact that crystal fractionation is easy to envision and somewhat easy to test, crystal fraction is often implicitly assumed to be the dominant process of magmatic differentiation.